Church bells ringing on our wedding day. Climbed in that limo and I rode away. Guess you'll always hear some people say they're never gonna make it. We settled in and we settled down in this quiet little seaside town. You were the rock I built my world around, and life won't ever break it. We are one.
I'm Kristen, and I'm going to tell you about, this video is going to be private because this is kind of personal stuff I'm about to talk about, but I'm going to talk about how I myself I am a recovered anorexic. I had anorexia when I was about 16, and it's a very hard thing to get over. Like back to when I was like 12 or 13, I was trying to lose weight. You know, it's ridiculous of how much, you know, even little kids are trying to lose weight and everything. And so for a while, I just always felt big. And I remember when I was like 12 or 13, I even lost weight then, and it felt good. So, when I got like 16, I was in a wellness class, and we were discussing a lot of stuff about health stuff. We talked a lot about how reducing calories can help you lose weight, and how a lot of exercise can help you lose weight, and we were talking about a lot of health stuff. And then next thing you know, I had healthy things on my mind, and I remembered what it felt like to lose weight, and it felt good. So I started thinking, well, I'm going to start losing weight. So I went on a diet. It started out as a healthy diet, and it worked a little bit, like maybe 2 or 3 pounds, but I felt like this isn't good enough. I still feel fat. I want to lose more. And I kept with the same diet, but it didn't like help me lose a lot of weight. I didn't feel satisfied. I didn't feel like it was enough. I wanted more. So I started going the unhealthy way about it, and I started like reducing my calories to like really unhealthy levels, to like, you know, I think it started off with like 700 calories a day, and I eventually got down to like 200 calories a day, and I would exercise a lot, and I ended up losing a lot of weight. I got down to 85 pounds eventually, and I lost my periods for a while, and I worried everyone around me. I remember everyone being so worried, and my mom one day just walked in and was like, this just isn't you. You know, she was all sad and she's crying, and it just made me feel so bad. And, you know, it felt like an accomplishment every time I'd lose weight. Every time I'd see the numbers go down on the scale, I'd feel like an accomplishment. And I don't know why. I remember going to bed sometimes, wondering if I was going to wake up. Because, like, I could, you know, like, I felt my heart beating so fast in my chest at that time. And, you know, at that time period, too, I had no energy to do anything. I was cold all the time. And I couldn't stay still for long, like, because I was, you know, so fragile, the bones in my body. And I remember one time, you know, when I was younger, I could go in bumper cars, have fun, you know, with my family and everything. And when I was going through anorexia, when I was getting on bumper cars, that hurt me so bad, just playing bumper cars, because my body was so fragile. Just bumper cars, just moving my body like this, hurt so bad. And I remember also when I was going through it also, I remember you could see so many bones in my body. It didn't even look pretty, but I didn't like the way it looked. I didn't feel like it looked very good, but I still felt like places in my body needed to be smaller. I still didn't feel happy. Even though I could see all the bones, I was really afraid of gaining weight. I was afraid of it getting out of control. I was afraid if I was to get better, I would get really fat. If I was to get better, so for a while I didn't want to get better for a while, and I tried to ignore the fact that I had a problem for a while. Tried to convince myself that it wasn't a problem, that I had a good skill of losing weight. Not everyone could do it, and I had a good skill at doing it. That's what I felt like, and I didn't realize how many people at the time it affected so many people around me. I was so consumed into it that I didn't pay attention to that. And as I was coming out of the anorexia, I was thinking, what was I thinking? I'll never do that again. Why did I even do that? Why did I do that to myself? And it affected so many people. And everyone was talking about how they were worried about me. And what helped me was my family. My family helped me get better. They started setting up consequences for me if I didn't eat so much that night. And it worked, And I would fight them against it so hard. I'm so happy they did. I basically feel like they saved my life, and my friends too. My friends helped me too. I don't know what I would have done without them, because it's almost like a self thing. Like you feel like you can't let yourself do it. So my thing is, I don't know if I could have done it without help, I wanted to get better at one point so bad. I just felt like I couldn't let myself. I don't know. I don't know why. I felt like maybe I'd lose control, and I felt like I would go nuts and get super duper fat if I tried to get better. So it took more than just me to get better. And that's my story. I thought I'd share it with you. And all right, thanks for watching. Bye.
True believers. It wasn't easy getting here today. Sometimes you stumbled or I lost my way, but every roadblock was a chance to see.